first saw this movie several days ago, I thought that this is just going to basically be one of those Pixar sequels like Cars 2 and all those other sequels that nobody asked for. And yes, this movie isn't something that people, including Toy Story fans, wouldn't ask for to have a continuation of Toy Story. But after watching the ending of this, I guess I can really understand that Pixar cannot, would never make Toy Story mediocre whatsoever. It just goes to show that they actually care about Toy Story, and if they're ever going to keep making sequels involving Toy Story, they would still put a lot of effort and care in it. Because I'm actually kind of surprised that this movie, while in my opinion it isn't as good, isn't as better as the other three films, I still think it's still a pretty standard sequel. Especially that this officially made Toy Story a quadrilogy. Now, this began with Bonnie moving to kindergarten, and she's upset because she can't bring a toy without doing Appreciation Day. I think that's how you pronounce it. So she decided to make Forky. And Forky thinks that he's trash, but Woody and the others try to convince him that he is a toy. Now there is a world trip going on where Bonnie brings all of her toys with her, and Forky decides to jump out of the vehicle, and then they still manage to get the convo, but Forky is at an antique store where we get to see a villain, which is probably not actually a villain, but I'm not going to spoil a lot, is the one taking over the antique store. Okay, maybe I spoiled that the fact that she's really not a villain, but, you know, considering the fact that this is the fourth Toy Story movie, I really didn't know what they're going to do when it involves the next villain after Stinky Pete and Lotso the Bell. I'm just saying. So, for the majority of this movie, it just involves Woody just trying to find Forky and try to get back to Bonnie's RV, while Buzz is just trying to find Woody. And, yes, Woody comes across Bo Peep, who is a more different character than who she used to be in the first two movies. And in this movie, at the beginning, instead of having point of view sequence from the characters from the humans playing the characters, all we get is a flashback. Well, we see the part where Bo Peep was released, and during the time where Andy was young, yeah, it was a flashback. And in here, Bo Peep is more of a survivor, while also enjoying the carnival with so many kids. And that's basically all I have to say about the story. I know not a lot to say, but I really, really, really need to keep spoilers away from this review. Now, if there's one thing that I'm actually kind of surprised at what this movie does differently than the other Toy Story films, it's pretty much the fact that instead of Andy taking care of his toy since he went to college, Bonnie is taking care of him. And Bonnie just isn't interested in Woody anymore. Yeah. But at the same time, she's mostly burned out. But considering the fact that this is Pixar we're talking about, it's the way of showing that kids just cannot be interested in the same toy repeatedly again and again. Although, I am kind of confused onto why Bonnie is just born out from Woody, since even though that in the last movie, she was so thrilled to play with Woody so many times, doing the parts where Woody is with Bonnie at her house, while the other characters are in Sunnyside Daycare. So I really think that this idea of what they had to do for Bonnie is actually kind of, well, to be honest, a bit lazy, but I think I can understand what they're going for. Now, if there's one thing that I actually enjoy of this movie is Ducky and Bunny. These are probably one of the best comic reliefs from any other Toy Story movie. I really think that they probably give out the best humor when it comes to the situations of when they have to help Woody and Buzz in the carnival, especially the moments that they had together. And I really think that they probably really make the movie way more watchable for the fourth time of Toy Story making the film. And I really think they probably did so much better when it comes to the ideas of what they did. I mean, if you look at the trailer, well, some of the TV spots, you see them completely tagging a grandmother, and Buzz completely say that that's never going to happen. That is just comedy gold, in my opinion. Even if it's kind of juvenile, since this is a TV, this is a rated G movie, I still think that they probably give out the best laughs in this entire movie. I mean, sure, there are some other characters who actually has a comedy of their own, have the humor of their own, but at the same time, I really think that Bunny and Ducky are the ones that could really make this movie way more better. Now, as for the villain, Gabby Gabby, I guess, well, considering the fact that this is the fourth time they're doing this, it's no surprise that the villain is going to be way better than Stinky Pete and Lotso the Bear. Because when you look at the other movies, yes, I know this is not Stinky Pete, but Al is still kind of a villain somehow. You can tell that they do have some motive since they are actually a toy. I mean, Stinky Pete wants to be part of a museum in Japan, while Lotso the Bear, well, is a abusive psychopath. No, seriously, he really is. After so many years of realizing what Lotso's plan is to completely fool the toys into going to the caterpillar room, I won't be surprised if he still acts the same way, even during the events of this movie. And no, he isn't in this movie, I'm just saying during the events. If there's one thing that makes this movie an understandable reason onto why Toy Story 4 didn't need to exist is the cast of supporting characters like Rex, Bullseye, Slinky, Mrs. Potato Head and Mr. Potato Head, and all Bonnie's toys. All they just do is just stay in the RV, and even the most comical characters like Rex don't usually do a lot of humor in this because, well, they barely go with Buzz with the other characters, which is actually kind of sad because in the second Toy Story film, Mr. Potato Head, Slinky, Ham, and Rex went with Buzz when they're just trying to save Woody from going to Japan. Then again, I think that they probably want to put some spotlight in the other characters like Ducky and Bunny, which isn't a problem, but at the same time, I really feel like these characters could have been executed something in this movie. I mean, sure, they probably did something they do stuff in the RV, but at the same time, this is pretty much Pixar's way of they can't focus on so much stuff, otherwise the movie will probably get more claustrophobic. That's something I actually realized when it comes to the other Toy Story films. They always put their effort on the story, because that's pretty much what people have been wanting to watch a movie of, is how they can execute of what they can do with the story. But other than that, we've seen Pixar doing that so many times in the films, well, minus the Cars movies. Now, let's go talk about the animation. And I gotta say, the animation is just basically a proof onto how far we've come. The first Toy Story film premiered in 1995, and then this movie came out of this year, and that's almost 15 years. just looking this image of Andy back to back, jeez, I honestly can't believe that a lot has changed over those years. And it's actually kind of a miracle that the fact that they made a fourth Toy Story so we can look at some of the animation in the other films. And I'm just saying, the animation in Toy Story 3 really looks good, but considering the fact it was earlier this decade, which is actually kind of surprising for all of us on how time is going so fast, which is, for the majority, we mostly feel bad because I actually kind of like my teenage life, but I'm just saying. But my point is that of how far the animation has come from Toy Story 3 to this movie, jeez. I just really think that this is pretty much a demonstration of people comparing four Toy Story movies together and how the animation has changed. Since Toy Story was the movie that completely made CGI animation films a thing. And the fact that CGI in the 1990s was being overused for far too much. Although I wasn't one of those people, but I can understand why people are just getting sick of the CGI wherever they go in theaters during that time. So, what do I think about Toy Story 4? Well, like I mentioned, it's not as bad as the other three films, mainly because it didn't really need to exist. When you look at the other films, mainly 1, 2, and 3, you can tell that they probably did so much effort when it comes to the continuation of what the toys are going to do for the next step. I mean, sure, the other movies involve around Andy since he owned the toys and he gave them to Bonnie. But watching a movie with only bits and pieces of Andy, while the majority of the movie just involves Bonnie completely enjoying her toys and the fact that Forky is lost, I would say that, well, looking at this, it kind of feels like a straight-to-DVD sequel, but with a big budget and with interesting ideas that it's probably why it was released in the big screen. I mean, every time I look at this, I just think that this movie only exists because, well, they wanted to expose another generation of Pixar fans, which is okay, but I think that I would recommend parents to show their children the three Toy Story movies instead of making a fourth one. I mean, I did enjoy some bits and pieces, and this is the type of movie where you turn off your brain to get away all the ideas of there's a fourth Toy Story movie. But other than that, I'm just if I ever going to watch this movie again, it won't be as many times as the other movies, mainly because, well, it's just there for probably to have another sequel. I mean, if there's one thing that I'm actually glad that this movie didn't do, is having the Star Command attitude that they had in the other three movies. In the first movie, Buzz thinks that he's still a Star Command until he came to the realization that he wasn't, since he wasn't able to fly. In the second film, we get another Buzz Lightyear with a belt thing around his waist, while he acts the Star Command attitude like the old Buzz in the first movie. And then in the third movie, Lotso completely changed the electronics on Buzz Lightyear to make him think that he's a Star Command again. In this movie, there is no Star Command attitude whatsoever. None whatsoever. And I'm actually kind of glad. The thing is, the Star Command attitude was one of the things that I think that the fourth Toy Story movie didn't need. I mean, when it happened in the third movie, it was obvious of a way to have the other characters stay in Sunnyside to make the security much more stronger. And when the other characters try to fix them again, when they try to fix them, Buzz was able to speak Spanish, which is probably one of the most infamous and hilarious moments in Toy Story 3. So if they did this again with the fourth Toy Story movie, it would probably be lazy writing and probably make the joke less funny and probably jumping the shark at this point. And that's probably a good thing, because when I watched this entire movie, there was no jumping the shark whatsoever with the idea of adding sequels. And it's actually kind of surprising that Pixar took the time that they need to make this movie. I mean, they got all the original actors from the other last movies, well, except the ones who have passed away, like Don Rickles and the voice of Slinky from the first two movies. But at the same time, I guess that they probably wanted to do this because, well, Tom Hanks was actually in tears when he saw the script that he was supposed to read for the movie. And what I mean by that is, it's mainly the ending. And like I said, I can't spoil the ending. The ending is probably something that is kind of like the last movie, but at the same time, really out of nowhere. And something you wouldn't even expect for Pixar to do with the most famous and popular franchise. So that's Toy Story 4. It isn't a terrible movie, and I really think that watching it in theaters is mostly worth it. But when it comes to be another sequel from Pixar, I guess at this point, this is pretty much of what they can do when it involves with sequels. Not saying that it's a bad thing, but I just think that this movie didn't need to exist. I mean, I did like it, and I actually kind of enjoy it, but not as much as the other three movies. I can give this movie in 7.8 out of 10. Not saying that it deserves, not just to let you know, you don't have to go, don't give this movie that rating. It doesn't deserve that kind of style of rating. You need to understand that they probably didn't know what to do when it comes to Toy Story 4. And just by watching of what the other three movies did, especially the ending from the third movie, I guess that watching this is just probably something to have the return of Bo Peep. And Bo Peep has a different character arc, unlike in the other two movies. So I really have to be honest, that whole arc is basically something kind of unique, since the original fans of the fourth Toy Story movie was going to have Woody just trying to find the Bo Peep. But I think that would not probably work, because it's really obvious that the toys are small enough to stay in the room that they're being taken care of. But other than that, this movie, it deserves a 7.8 out of 10. So overall, it's still in theaters. So if you're interested, mainly because it's probably the only Pixar movie of this year, then go to your nearest theater and go watch this movie. As much as it's not as great as the other three movies, it's still worth the watch. I'm Lonely Fanboy Foy here, and I'll see you next time.